Dobra, witam was serdecznie w nowej serii Ace Combat 7. Pobrałem specjalnie gierkę, żeby ją przejść. Rozpoczniemy kampanię od nowa. Zagramy sobie na trudnym aż poziomie trudności.
Does the color of the sky mean anything special to you? It does to me. A hell of a lot. When I close my eyes, the sky in my dreams is a deep, dark blue.
To chyba cicho jest gra, to nabierzemy zaraz podgłosze.
Pilots have been in my family for 4 generations. Flying's in my DNA. Even so, my grandpa didn't want me joining the Air Force. He lost faith in the Ocean Air Defense the day my dad died in battle.
You know, Avi, I wish you could see what it's like up there. Cruising above the clouds, the dark blue of the stratosphere. Nothing beats being at the controls and seeing it from the cockpit. Look here.
Gramps tossed a magazine over to me with an article. Unmanned fighters are no longer a dream, it read. Pilots taking to the skies will soon be a distant memory.
I don't see anything good coming from that.
Know what? Lying smack dab in the middle of the desert west of here, there's a bunch of planes from the last war. Some of them have been mothballed, but most of them are just rusted piles of junk waiting to be scrapped. Gramps was really good friends with the super there, so he got to take whatever he wanted, no questions asked. That's how we got the parts to build our own plane. Now, when I say we, I mean me, my grandpa, and his old war buddies. I cut my teeth working with those geezers. They taught me their skills and some dirty jokes. But with their aging eyeballs and whatnot, I ended up having to do most of the work myself. I was at the airstrip doing some flight training when I saw it. A prototype drone. It wasn't much of a plane, more of a trash can with wings.
I've had it all you want, kid. But technology's always changing. If you don't keep up with it, it'll leave your ass behind.
It took 6 years and 8 months to get that engine running. And it took us another year and a half after that to finally get the balance of the airframe just right. I'd gone from being a little girl to, well, still a girl, just older. But now, I was all alone. Wherever the souls of my gramps and his pals are flying, I hope it's peaceful. Then, finally, I was ready to break the sound barrier. All this plane could do was take off, accelerate, and fly up. Then I saw Osia's fighters. They were tailing something. A drone. They were going full out chasing that thing. Doing 30 Gs at least.
F-15.
Damn, I've never seen anything move that fast. It had a rose painted on it. The Erusian emblem. But that country's a whole continent away from here.
Crap. You should have been wearing a vest with you, piece of junk. Should have built a deterrent too.
A cóż, zestrzelili ją. Ma być koniec gry, ale tak my na szczęście nie gramy. Nie lubię tej baby.
Settle down. instrumental in helping to maintain peace in Yuzhia as members of the International Union Peacekeeping Force. Until today. Earlier, our radar site informed us that a group of unidentified aircraft was approaching. Communication systems went down immediately afterwards. We are led to conclude that they have attacked the site. Here's your mission. It's possible that the Yuzhan ceasefire agreement has been broken for the first time in over a decade. As of today, the Fort Gray's airbase squadron of the IUPF has been put on high alert. All members who have been ordered to sortie, fly there immediately. Find the unidentified craft, then use your weapons to round them up and force them to land. If the hostiles counterattack, then you will...
What the hell was that? There's smoke!
We're under attack. Numerous unidentified aircraft confirmed overhead.
What? How is that possible?
The tank farm to the north has been bombed.
Many injured.
Scramble. All units, take off and eliminate the unidentified craft attacking the base. This is not a drill.
Jesteśmy atakowani. Super. No nie, jeszcze grę przeszedłem. Więc mam niestety drzewko samolotów odblokowane i to jest startować się nie da, jak w poprzednich grach. Więc ja po prostu będę tym grał X-02S. Tak długo jak będzie mi się to podobało oczywiście i sobie będę po prostu blokowywał dalsze rzeczy dostępne. A to myślę, że weźmiemy sobie te 4 AM. To jest samolot rosyjski z tego co wiem. Bardzo dobry wam powiem, bo przyszedłem sobie grę raz. Po dwóch ostatnich nic nie zrobiłem. Jesteśmy Trigger. Okay. Mieszamy. Tak, chwila, moment jest. Powodzenia, dobra. Lecimy w tamtą stronę, tam się młodzież pojawi. Mogę się przełączyć na te rakietki. A jest tu 95. Jedna rakieta wystarczy, żeby go zestrzelić. Testowałem. No, poszła rakieta. Bum! To jest po nim. Sobie włączałem tą mapę. Choć 2700 km na godzinę. Więc tutaj że jest europejski system oznaczenia amerykański. No widzę, tam są. To jest prosta misja, to żeby się nauczyć latania w tej grze. To jest praktycznie w każdym miejscu combat, że pierwsza misja to jest po prostu lecieć, żeby coś zastrzelić. Te migi też są jakimiś prostymi celami. Jak na start. Tam jest nie. Bang, wszystkie. Okej, teraz się tu pojawiam, o właśnie. Ja to misja jest 24 minuty, ja tego nie rozumiem. Jesteśmy za nimi, chyba wszystkie spadną momentalnie, o właśnie. Ci wydaje, że po tych strzeleniach to już atem powinniśmy zostać. Zresztą to chyba ten specjalny myśliwiec misji, żeby go zbombić. Tak, to jest specjalny... każdej części pojawiają się takie pseudoasy, czy tak to nazwę, które można zbombić, czy jakieś tam warunki spełnić, żeby było możliwość do zrobienia. Kurwa, co jest? Nie mogę... A, bo zły przycisk klikałem. Wysyłam mnie. Teraz już każdy dostałem myszę o to. Zapomniałem przyciski, bo zamiast klikać ten od uwalniania klikałem od skrętu. O, to jest ostatnia fala bombowców. Jak się zestrzeli z końca misji? Bang. Zostajmy wrócę na niego. Ale przymanewrował się tego miga, więc go powinienem zaraz w tyłek wejść. Wiesz, jest trochę trudno. A, takie to poszły. Strzelony, nice. Teraz po tych. Wpadną te rakiety w tych. Podło. Są od boku, nie ma co. Nie, jak już tam manewrować próbują. Po prostu się lock. Pewnie jestem przyzwyczajony do nowego pada, bo przecież miałem z Xboxa. Teraz mam z Xboxa 1 i trochę inaczej siedzi. Bo się przerzucę z powrotem na poprzedni. Chyba teraz zastrzelam, że koniec misji. Nie? Bang. Rakiety. Bang. Nice. Jestem tu. Rakiety, to jakby nie trafić. Trafiani. Jest GG. No, spoko, szukno, okej. Zstrzeliłem większość maszyn, kurwa, bez przesady. Nie. Tak, bo to UN to jest takie trochę... Takie oceańskie siły pokojowe na USA, które pilnowały, że wojny nie było i tak pilnowali, że wojna wybuchła właśnie. I poprzednia władza z Ace Combat 4 wróciła w sumie do Eruzji. Bena jest chyba córką tego, co rządził podczas akcji Ace Combat 4. Tam jest zwykle powtórki, to jest debriefing.
assessing the damage to the base. We have confirmed that the aircraft carrier Albatross was sunk. We know the attacking bogeys were from Arusha. International Union peacekeeping force bases all over the Yuuzhan continent were attacked in the same way. The damage is severe. Many wars are lost by failing to recover from the opening blows. That means successfully retaliating was very important. You may have turned the tides of battle here. You have our thanks.
Może. Idziemy dalej. A, tego miga odblokowałem. Następna misja od razu.
As of 1 p.m. today, the Kingdom of Arusia has declared war on the Ocean Federation. As soon as the news broke out, enemy aircraft began bombing Ocean territory, causing widespread destruction. The Air Defense Force has released a statement saying this violent attack was carried out by drones. They speculate the drones were secretly transported to Ocea in shipping containers and launched remotely. The Secretary of the Navy has stated that the enemy was targeting naval ports across the country. According to the Secretary, all of the nation's aircraft carriers, including one still under construction, sustained severe damage in the attacks. We have yet to hear back from the department as to the fate of Ocean carriers currently at sea. Hold on. The International Space Elevator, which is being built in southern Yuuzhan, has been seized by the Arusian Army. Reports say former President Harling was touring the site at the time, but his current whereabouts are unknown. Our sources in government tell us it was Harling's policies regarding the space elevator that caused economic frictions in the area, and which ultimately led to this war. Located near Arusha, on the continent of Yuuzhan, the space elevator has been under construction for some time now. The Executive Office of the Ocean Federation has declared a national state of emergency. They have ordered all its armed forces, including Yuuzhan peacekeepers, to mobilize and make the necessary preparations to launch an immediate counterattack. Ladies and gentlemen, our country is officially at war. Stay tuned for further updates.
Breaking news from ENN. Ocea launched an attack on the capital today, striking Farbanti from their aircraft carrier, the Kestrel II. After a brutal battle, the Arusian Air Force successfully repelled them. During the air raid, the Ocean Air Force fired missiles at the city and managed to shoot down a number of Arusian fighters. Some of the disabled planes then crashed into residential areas.
No cóż. Wojna, niestety.
The world was screwed. 20 years ago, the Earth got slammed by an asteroid. Yuuzhan was on the wrong side of the planet and got hit. Hard. Refugees swarmed the Arusian Republic, the biggest country on the continent, plunging it into chaos. They were desperate and started a war, one they had no hope of winning.
No.
That's the war my dad fought and died in. The biggest nations from two continents went head to head, and the so-called righteous Oceans struck the deal that ended it. They fancied themselves the only nation that could bring peace and stability to the world. They even tried saving the Yuuzhans, still suffering from the disaster. That's how a space elevator, stretching way up into the sky, ended up being built in Yuuzhan, paid for by the Oceans. President Harling said he did it out of compassion for his fellow humans. But to the folks in Arusha, it looked like Ocea was moving in to take over. Arusha went from being a republic back to being a kingdom. When they started this new war, they managed to get the drop on everyone. The second the declaration hit the news, Arusian forces took control of the space elevator without spilling a single drop of blood. President Harling was touring the elevator when it happened and disappeared. Then, while that was going on, the Arusian ships that were docked all around Ocea released a swarm of drone fighters.
O, Grunder, proszę bardzo. Ale nie belgijska firma.
They were capable of doing what they did that day. With pinpoint accuracy, they managed to take out everything that was military. And not a single civilian was hurt in the process. Ocea pissed lots of people off with their huge military presence around the world. Arusha didn't have the same reach, but they could hit their targets faster and cleaner. And when all this was going down, I just so happened to be in my flying drag racer.
Jeszcze nie zginęłaś, babo.
In case you were wondering, yeah, I survived.
No tak to byś do nas nie mówiła. Wow.
I crashed in a bombed out Ocean Air Force base. Then, got arrested for breaking wartime aviation laws or some crap. The world went from being at peace to being at war, all in the blink of an eye.
Zrobiła zbrodnia wojenna, a tak rozwiązanie precyzyjne uderzenia, żeby nie zabić cywili.
For company, I had some court-martialed soldiers. And remember those mothballed planes I told you about before? They were loaded on the ship too. We headed off down south for several days, and then swung east. That's how I got here. I was thousands of kilometers from Arusia, on the opposite side of the Yuzhen continent. For a port, it was dull as hell. It had three rusty patrol boats. And the base? The fences were topped with razor wire, the tower had a searchlight and machine guns, and a truck with a gun turret was parked in front of the gate. Its gun was aimed at the yard. This was a prison.
Osa to taka w sumie takie Stany Zjednoczone w końcu. I też mają mundury praktycznie amerykańskie na sobie.
The whole place was just one big fat lie. The only reason I was here is because they knew I'd restored a supersonic plane. They wanted me to make something out of the mothballed planes they brought, that they could park on the fake runway. Can you believe that shit? So, I tried to escape. They found out and set the dogs on me.
Idziemy sobie jeszcze na misję i zakończę nagranie. Taki dłuższy na start filmik.
Has made a declaration to the Ocean Federation and all countries on the Yuzhen continent stationing the IUN peacekeeping force that we are now at war. Right after the declaration was made, surprise attacks began around the continent that have inflicted major damage to our armed forces. Forces aligned with Arusia are currently appearing throughout Yuzhen. The combination of these forces has overwhelmed the majority of the continent, and they are now encroaching on us in the east. Additionally, the multinational space elevator has been seized by the Arusian military.
After
the previous war, the space elevator became both a symbol of peace and a valuable asset in the fight against growing energy concerns. Whoever has control of it will have enormous influence over the entire continent.
Wszystko tam winno być się rozpędziło.
The Fort Grey's Air Base Squadron has been entered into the order of battle to reclaim the elevator as an advanced element. First, you will attack all hostiles coming in the east of Schofield Plateau to stop any interference with the Allied ground troops. The enemy has deployed several vehicles equipped with anti-air radar along the roads. You are to destroy them. They should not pose much of a threat. However, there is a high likelihood that the attack will draw more enemy air support. If that happens, fight them off swiftly and establish air superiority.
Oko, mordo. Nasza cena. Rozpocznę misję. Wezmę tego znowu z RTM. Weźmiemy sobie te rakietki. One są do celów naziemnych. Szczerze, nie podoba mi się fabuła w tej grze. Najlepszą fabułę miała piątka, chyba Ace Combat, i potem zanim jest...
It's popping off now,
Stary czary? Ten wóz w takim razie. Właśnie chyba teraz trafiłem. Nice. Zawrotka, bęk. Dagon. Nice. Kudu, ale zniszczony, ciekawe. Powiem, że te... Prawie, że mogą strzelać rakietami we śmigłowce. Ja miałem dodatkowy przycisk, zapominam o nim. Mam jeszcze 19, no w tej grze jest dużo amunicji. Przeciwnicy do Ace Combat 5 trzeba było naprawdę oszczędzać. Zrobię to mapa. Jeszcze nie rozbiję w jakiś sposób. Halo, do mnie. Dobra, rozbił się cywilna i na wojna. Co się dziwić. Chyba skupiam się na zastrzeleniu tych fajerów. Tam jest coś białego jeszcze. Nie trafiłem co innego kąta pobyć. 15 minut ładnie. Co to jest? Na wszelki wypadek. Jeszcze coś koło jakieś C-17. Trzeba je zniszczyć. Co to walnęło? Walnę. Aha, drony.
What happened? Status report. Multiple bogus.
jeden dron mniej. O, tu jest kolejny as, który chce strzelić. Nice, strzelony. Teraz sobie tymi dronami może się pobawić. O, ponad 6 minut będzie materiał. Ale są niestety o tyle zjebane, że oni tak manewrować potrafią w zajebiście. To irytuje, trzeba jakieś na 1000 metrów, za nimi dopiero odpalać te rakiety, bo... Czy jak on manewruje? Może teraz nie zgubi ich? Nie, nie zgubili. Zestrzelamy. Czysto. Wszystko zniszczone. Wracamy do bazy.
You've given us air superiority by destroying their radar. The first barrier keeping us from retaking the space elevator is gone. Now is the time to group up and begin the counteroffensive. Let us reclaim what is ours.
Dziękuję za oglądanie. Zobaczcie w przyszłym odcinku z Kombacierem. Cześć.